We need to love one another. Why? Because God first loved us. And if we love one another, we are showing that we have God in us because we love. Loving others shows that we have the Spirit of God in us. So it isn't enough to go about professing Christ. It isn't enough to say that you love God, but you must have action just as God had action. He gave his son. Jesus had action. Jesus laid down his life for the sheep. Praise God. So as Christians, as those who claim to be followers of Jesus Christ, we must have action. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in the passage which I shared with you, whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwelleth in him, and he is of God. Now, that wasn't a direct quote, the last part of the phrase, but by confessing that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, that is another evidence that we are of God. Who is God? God is love. In this passage, which I've shared with you, for those who have come late, 1 John chapter 4, verses 11 through 21, we heard that there is no fear in love, but perfect love casteth out all fear. Fear creates torment in us. And so if we have perfect love, we must cast out fear. The Bible says again, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. The Bible says, God for us is more than the whole world against us. Praise the Lord. Oh, that's a blessing in itself. Now, let's look at verse 20. Verse 20 is a very difficult verse to swallow. The Bible says, if we say that we love God and we hate our brother, then the truth is not in us. Why? Because how can you love a God who you have never seen? How can you love a God whom you've never seen and then hate your brother who you've seen? So I challenge you. Sometimes within a family, there's a dispute. Something happened long ago. Something may have happened yesterday. But you cannot say you love God and hate your brother. You cannot say you love God and hate your sister. You cannot say you love God and hate your mother. You cannot say you love God and hate your father. You cannot say you love God and hate your aunt. You cannot say you love God and hate your uncle. You cannot say you love God and hate your cousins. So, let us love one another, and love is action. One of the most wonderful things that I experience every day is love. And it's love from co-workers, it's love from family, it's love from friends, it's love from acquaintances and people you meet. I enjoy seeing a smile on a face. I enjoy seeing children have fun. And I enjoy small actions of love. I had a wonderful time around the holiday season. I had children share things with me. I got a brownie and I got a cupcakes and I had cookies and I got a special kind of popcorn that chocolate was put over top of it, and I got a lovely scarf. And but more important than what I received is the love that I felt from those who shared their love with me. The thought began with love, because when you do something loving, it starts with love in someone's heart. It starts with an idea. And I want to encourage us. Of course, the Bible speaks about the words from our mouths. And of course, the words from our mouths start in our hearts. And what we say comes out, it's issued from the heart. So I want to encourage us to love. I want to encourage us to make sure that we think on those things that are perfect, that are true. If there's any good thing, to think on the good things. Thank you for joining me. This has been Meditation. I'm your host, Dr. Pat Dingell. We have shared with you words of love from the Word of God. 1 John chapter 4, verses 1 through 8. Then I shared 1 John chapter 4, verses 11 through 21. Go and be blessed today. Go and be blessed this evening. Go and be blessed the rest of your lives. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing you again.